Saros, it's time to pay your dues. It sure is beautiful. On the contrary, Dr. Thomas, this place has a lot for us. Instead of new home, how about vacation home? We don't age, we don't hunger, somehow metabolism's maintained. As well as going beyond those limitations. I hate to say it, but I agree with a few of Saros' points here. His means are horrifying, but the Phantom Realm offers much to the people of Luna. We should not dismiss it out of hand. The issue isn't the Anti-Realm itself, it's Saros' methods, and humanity's short-sightedness. But they didn't have a choice. Saros would actually have a point if the comet was only a few weeks away, but we have a year. If he was prepping the Phantom Realm as a backup home, then this would be a different story. I mean, in the very grand scheme of things, one life is meaningless, but to the people of Luna, to the people of Earth, one life is precious. The universe doesn't care, but the people do. Phase Punch! Again and again, even with all the advantages you had, we still managed to pull through time and time again. If he hasn't already. Wasn't it obvious by now? He's been responsible for thousands upon thousands of deaths. Taya Gray was likely one of the first ones. Unfortunately, his antimatter form is also driving him a bit crazy. Everyone's hit the caps lock. Mad scientist much? Final boss time! Saros EX.
Relic sword! Take this!
We never even managed to defeat the regular Saros. He was completely immune to our attacks. Sheesh, that attack's gonna be a pain to dodge.
Relic sword. Take this.
Excalibur.
Wait. Over phase.
Relic sword. Flash!
Will the gambit pull off?
Excalibur!
Yes!
Did it!
Saros got absolutely wrecked. Through sufficient grinding and the black market, if anything, a lot of tanks should go to those upgrade chip sellers. Damn. Is it duo or trio? Oh goody, it's an entire alien civilization. And if they constructed one comet, who's to say they didn't construct more of them? Having the antimatter form as a backup plan, I'd say is a good idea, but it shouldn't be the primary solution. Uh-oh. It's what Nickel was warning about, why he was so concerned of using his antiform in the first place. A dark form of evolution. Whoa. You're kind of late to the party. Super Saros. Yeah, take a tactical retreat. We'll handle him. Just gonna stack some attack multipliers. Oh, by the way, Rain Squad, if we end up perishing, please protect the people of Luna. The Ultimate Hero Tetra is ready! Final battle routine, set and execute! Chaos! Oh man, talk about hard to dodge. But not immune to being stunned. Let's go for funny. Can't do that yet. I'm gonna give him one more turn. It's like Photon Field with the mashing. Only 120. Boo. Oh my gosh. Welp, A rank time. Yes. Goodbye, Saros.
Excalibur!
Nope, one more turn. I see. Thanks, Tetra. Tetra gets the final blow.
You're one step closer to justice.
GG! Saros has been defeated. Or has he? We can go for a round three. We have plenty of items to spare. Quick, start consuming some Master Energies. And some cheesecake bars. We got more backup. We need more power. Did it work? I guess we're back on Luna. More like made one ourselves. Uh-oh. He's fought us through. Kronos! But yeah, this is the first, or technically second Merc we've encountered who can talk in full sentences. I say technically second because of the bandit leader. Ultra Buster, go! Still not powerful enough. Quick, everyone, donate your spare Lux. She's turned blue. That's her final attack. Hope and determination. Final button mashing. Reduced to an anticore. A rather fitting fate. Hey, it could come in handy later. Time for the big reveal. Show us who truly you are, Kronos. I knew it. This game didn't even try hiding it that well. Most of the game's twists can be seen a mile away. I mean, Sylveon was making jokes about this back in the first stream, and me as well later. And she made it, surviving for over 10 years. That's what she was trying to do back then, way back in Chapter 1. The one word that came true continuously was protect. Thank you, Guardia. Hang on a second. Perhaps we can construct our own vessels and place the anticores in them. That way, we can restore some of the lost humans. Indeed, Taya is a major player in saving the day. Tetra deserves a lot of credit as well. She wasn't one of the two main protagonists, but she's certainly a very active sidekick. In several scenarios, she was basically instrumental to saving the day. Taya's not gone forever. There's still a chance to bring her back permanently. Not just to you, but also to the people of Luna. This is one major threat down. We still have Comet Coda to worry about. And of course, Nemesis. However, that part of the story will likely be saved for LunarLux 2. May our Lux forever shine bright. Fight, Bella, for everlasting peace. And thus, this concludes my blind let's play of LunarLux, an overall okay to decent turn-based action-adventure JRPG. I'll provide my overall thoughts in text, because I have quite a few of them. And once again, I thank the developers for providing me a key for their title. It's really appreciated. So, if you enjoyed this Let's Play, please rate, comment, favorite, and or subscribe, as they all help out the channel. Don't forget to follow me on X, Mastodon, Co-host, and Blue Sky as well, and join my Discord server, as I regularly post updates there. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you all in a future Let's Play.